Currently, the graduation rate for engineering school is right around 60%. So for every 10 students who begin, only 6 make it all the way through. What do these 6 students have that these 4 don't?
Clearly, it's because they aren't smart enough.
Wrong. The difference is a little something called self-discipline. I know what you're thinking.
Yeah, but engineering school is really hard, and I just don't think I'm smart enough.
Okay, you are smart enough, and I'm gonna prove it to you. Let's go through a little example. Let's say you want to run a marathon. How would you go about accomplishing something like that? So here's present day you. Maybe you can only run a couple miles. And then here's future you, who can run 26.2 miles. The question is, how does this person turn into this person? This is not a trick question. You know that if you train hard enough and consistently enough, your muscles will adapt and strengthen, and your stamina will go from a couple miles all the way up to 26.2 miles, right? We all know that. The question is, what's the real force behind this transformation? It's freaking self-discipline, that's what. Self-discipline is what empowers you to show up and put in the work necessary every day to transform from this person into this person. Okay, so that's easy enough, right? Now let's talk about school. What if you want to get an engineering degree? How would you go about accomplishing something like that? Okay, so here you are at the beginning of school. Your brain can only handle a little bit of algebra. Maybe you can study for an hour or two without feeling totally exhausted. Then here's your brain at the end of school. Can handle high-level math, very complex science and engineering topics, and can study for hours and hours and hours on end. So the question is it possible to do that? Can your brain go from this to this?
You're damn right it's possible.
Now I know what you're thinking.
Running long distances and getting an engineering degree are not the same.
Yeah. It's actually exactly the same. It's just a different body part that needs strengthened. The fact is, your brain's ability to focus, comprehend, and endure can be strengthened through disciplined exercise and stimulation, just like your muscles can.
Whoa!
And it's all made possible by this awesome thing called neuroplasticity. Now, I'll do a longer video on neuroplasticity later, but just to summarize, it defines how your brain is not a constant structure, right? It's not unchanging. Based on what you're feeding it, what you're telling it to do, it will reallocate resources and build new neural pathways based on what you're giving it, right? So maybe that math class is really hard right now, but as long as you keep showing up with discipline, right, your brain will adapt and strengthen where it needs to over time. So you can begin to look at your homework and studying and going to class, right, as kind of your mental treadmill or your mental dumbbells, right? You know, you lift weights, you run, and over time your legs and your arms get stronger. Keep going to class, keep studying, keep doing your homework, and your brain will get the hint and it will reallocate stuff and get stronger where it needs to. Trust me on that. If that wasn't true, there's no way that I would have gotten an engineering degree. I mean, I barely passed algebra in high school. I scored a 17 on the ACT. So to be able to go from that to a master's degree in engineering tells you that your brain's ability to focus, comprehend, and endure can totally be strengthened just like your muscles can. That's why self-discipline is the main ingredient to you getting any degree you want. With enough self-discipline, you can increase your capability to focus, endure, and comprehend enough to match whatever school throws at you. Right? We all know that if you put in the time and energy, you can change your physical body, you can strengthen your muscles to do whatever you need them to do. So you should view your brain the same way. Once you view your brain the same way you do a muscle, you realize that the most important variable becomes self-discipline. Right? Maybe you can't run 20 miles today, but you know that if you just keep showing up, keep putting in the work, then eventually you'll be able to. So maybe today that problem or that topic doesn't really make sense to you right now. Maybe it's really confusing, But just keep showing up, keep trying different ways to understand it, keep asking different questions, and eventually your brain will adapt and you'll start to comprehend. Your ability to comprehend and understand will increase. So with that knowledge, don't freak out about your IQ or how smart you think you are or kind of what you struggle with right now, because you know that all that stuff can change, right? With self-discipline and showing up every day and keep hitting it, right? Keep studying, keep exercising that brain. You know that you'll get there eventually, right? Your brain will adapt, you'll get stronger, and you'll be able to do these things. That's why I say self-discipline is the most important ingredient into you getting the degree you want. I hope you enjoyed that video. You know, if you did, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future videos. And if you want to know more about how self-discipline played a huge role in my success through school and more about how you can develop strong self-discipline for yourself, be sure you check out my book. I'll put a link for that in the description. But until next time, thanks for watching and keep up the good work.